Hey, what's going on, guys? Hope you're doing awesome possum today. In this video, I will be doing a quick overview of all 5 hermits found in the Norse lands DLC for Kingdom 2 Crowns. Alright, there are some pretty exciting new hermits in this DLC, so be sure to watch the whole video. Okay, up first on island number 1 is the Horn Hermit. He's gonna cost you 1 gem and 1 coin to unlock. He provides you the ability to upgrade your walls with a large horn, which you can then use to summon all of your archers and knights to that specific wall for one night. Summoning all of your units to one wall is really only recommended during blood moons or after you've cleared an entire side of an island and only have to worry about the greed coming from one direction. Now, if you accidentally sound the horn and call all of your units by mistake, don't worry, you can still use the horn a second time to cancel the call, which will make a different sound and your units will return to their normal duties. In order to upgrade a wall with a horn, first you need to make sure that the wall is upgraded to a level 5 or a level 6, and then use a coin to pick up the Horn Hermit and take him to the wall you want to upgrade. Now, to help aid you in knowing which walls are ready to be upgraded with a horn, a ghost will appear when you pick up the hermit, which will then guide you to the appropriate walls. Upgrading a wall with a horn is going to cost you 12 coins. If you already have a horn on a level 5 wall and you want to upgrade that wall to a level 6, don't worry, the horn will automatically reappear once you do the upgrade. Up next on island number 2 is the Beer Hermit. This connoisseur of adult beverages is gonna cost you 4 gems and the standard 1 coin to unlock. This guy essentially replaces the Baker Hermit from the base game. He can be used to convert a level 4, 5, or 6 archer tower into a brewery for 18 coins. The brewery allows you to purchase and stock up to 5 mugs of beer at a time for 4 coins each. Now, the beer is going to attract vagrants who will automatically come running towards the brewery once they smell the hops in the air. When a vagrant consumes a mug of beer, he will be converted into a citizen automatically. Now, if you want to save yourself some coins, you can always intercept the vagrant before he reaches the beer and hire him for 1 coin like you always can, leaving the beer untouched and ready to attract more vagrants. Needless to say, this is very helpful because it has the potential to save you an immense amount of time that you would otherwise spend running back and forth to the vagrant camps each day to manually recruit citizens. Next on the list is the Fire Tower Hermit. This guy is unlocked on Island 3 for 3 gems and the usual 1 coin. As far as I'm concerned, this hermit is the MVP of Norse lands. He grants you the ability to upgrade a level 4, 5, or 6 archer tower into a fire tower for 15 coins. So fire towers use one archer that shoots flaming arrows that can light enemies on fire, as well as one builder who throws small bombs that light small patches of ground on fire. It has a very long range, with the flaming arrows being able to shoot all the way across the screen in some cases. Needless to say, this is a very powerful tower and is capable of burning tons of greedlings and softening up the breeders, making them much more manageable for your other archers to take care of. The next one up is the Stable Hermit, who was found on island number 4 and unlocked for 1 gem and 1 coin. This guy allows you to upgrade a level 2 farm into a stable for 8 coins. You can attract and store a mount at your stable by purchasing a pitchfork for a citizen from the stable itself. The pitchforks cost 5 coins each, and 1 pitchfork equals 1 mount. So, you'll need to hire multiple pitchfork farmers if you want access to all of your mounts. And as far as I can tell, each stable can hold a maximum of 3 mounts. So if you want access to every mount in the game, you'll need multiple stables. Aside from granting you easy access to all of your mounts, the stable also has the added benefit of reducing the cost of switching mounts down to just 3 coins each. This makes it very efficient for switching between your primary mount and the golden boar, for example, if you need to generate some quick cash. The fifth and final hermit, the Berserker Hermit, can be found on island number 6. He's going to cost you 3 gems and the 1 coin. He functions somewhat similarly to the Knight Hermit from the base game. He allows you to replace a level 4, 5, or 6 archer tower with a Berserker tower for 15 coins. The Berserker tower then allows you to purchase a drink for 8 coins that will attract and upgrade one Berserker. When the Berserker obtains the drink at the tower, he will replace his dual axes with one very large battle axe. And I'm not totally sure about these specific stats yet, but he appears to gain a significant damage increase and an even larger health increase. This upgrade makes the Berserker much more viable against larger waves of greed, especially when going one-on-one with some of the tougher enemies like the Breeders. I recommend keeping these towers close to the center of your kingdom, due to the fact that the towers themselves cannot house any actual form of defense like archers, so it's best to keep the actual archer towers at your front lines. Well, that's it for this video, guys. Hopefully you found it useful. And as always, if you know any tips or tricks, feel free to leave them down in the comments. And with that, I will see you fine folks in the next one.